Don't worry, terrible actor Dylan. Today we're going to learn how to easily and accurately get rid of the flicker in your shot. Today's fix does involve a plugin, and before you click off, let me say that if you're planning on making videos for a while, or you really just want to accurately fix your footage, this is a great investment. It has saved my footage a handful of times. So this plugin, which I am just a fan of and I'm not sponsored by any means, is called Flicker Free from Digital Anarchy. So here's how to use it to remove flicker. Drag the plugin onto your footage and click the preset option. You'll notice there are tons of flicker removing presets to fit the cause of the flicker in your shot. Most of the time, flicker is caused by LED lights, so I choose one of these options 9 times out of 10, but slow motion and time-lapse flicker removal has also come in handy. Once you choose the option you want, I'd suggest clicking detect motion, especially if your shot has any type of motion in it, obviously. This is really what separates the plugin from the MacGyver method that you'll see online, which is duplicating the same clip over top of the original, moving it one frame over, and then changing the opacity. This MacGyver method works sometimes, but it often introduces this glow-like motion blur that doesn't look natural. Flicker Free detects the motion in your shot and completely removes that glow-like blur. Most of the time, I don't even need to mess with any of these other options, but if it is really not working for you as much as you'd like, you can tweak the deflicker with these. It's important to note that this is render heavy, so I would suggest that you add the plugin right before you export. I'd also be avoiding the elephant in the room if I didn't mention that it is unfortunately not the cheapest plugin, but it has saved my shots and projects that I needed to deliver to clients, so to me that price tag was well worth it considering I'll have access to it for a lifetime. Let me know if you guys have any questions below, and subscribe if you enjoy this type of content and want to continue improving and learning about filmmaking and editing. I post at least one new video every week. Have a great day, guys.